There's a friend I visit when I cannot recognize myself. When I'm at my best pain, he teaches me how to mask myself with my mother's watermarks. How to be a red hair lady when black feels like a nightmare dying for love. And how to suck all my marrows dry and still be mouth watering in men's eyes. He reminds me how vital my pain is, that each wound is an art waiting for recognition, a healing moment for a depressed podium hosting death, and a happy auditorium when this gets creative. He also told me that soon enough we'll all lose color, so I better embrace it in black or red, but never white, cause sometimes this war zone is better than an empty clock in my father's crippled hands. It is better than being empty as white. So ever since then, I started wearing black at weddings and nothing when I'm on holy ground. All of this to prove that my tongue have nothing to do with my skin unless he is around, that his touch resides better than the earth's clouds in my mother's tongue. It anoints the past with waves from places I've never been to, places I don't think I want to go, places that brought us here, where we paint our scars for people that only come to create more, where we find ourselves comparing our sins in each other's skin until we burn our cloth with hunger. This is a friend I visit when I cannot recognize myself. He also taught me how to turn bleeding thorns to an applause.